to create multiple screen effects like this? It's actually not that hard. Now let's get started. First, you want to find a picture that's like this, which have different line, so you can put the videos at different part. Then remove the background of it, like this. I use remove.bg. You can check out my previous tutorial if you want to see more details on how to remove background. I will include the pictures and music in my template folder in the description in the link, so you can use it if you want, or use your own. Then click on new project. Select the video that has the music. Click on the video. Extract audio. Let's say if you want to use your own picture, you can just click on the clip. Then click on replace. Go to photo and select the photo that you want to use. Then click on the audio, match cut, auto generate, select bit 2. I'm going to zoom in this audio and then add 3 bits at the beginning, at the like this. Then I'm going to zoom in the timeline so I can see the bit a little bit better. Go to the first bit, overlay, add overlay. Then you can select pictures or video. Then adjust the size of it to make sure you cover the part that you want it to be at. Then click on mask. Then click on split. You can use split or fill strip, it doesn't matter that much. And then align it to match the line like that. You can also adjust this icon to make the edge a little bit blur if you want. Then go to the next bit, add overlay, select the second video, move it to the second place. Like this one, you can see it's on the pole, but it doesn't matter because we will cover it later after we finish everything. So pretty much you just repeat the same process, click on mask and then use split. If it's like this, you can rotate or just click on inward so it will be on the other direction. Then go to the next one. For this one, you can see the line doesn't align perfectly parallel. I will adjust the layer order after I import all 6 overlay videos, which the second layer will cover this one. For this one, we're going to click on mask. It doesn't matter if you use split or fill strip. And then just make sure to align it to match the top one. Then go to the next one, add overlay. Depends on the video you have, so you might want to use split or you want to use the fill strip. I'm just going to use the split here. You can see sometimes it might be freeze like this and you cannot see the picture being moved. What you can do is to exit out the project and then go back again. Then it should show. Now I'm going to change the order of them. Make sure you are at the point where you can see all 6 layers so you can see the change. If you use the same picture as mine, then click on the first overlay, click on layer. I'm going to have this one at 6, which means this overlay would be on the top. Second one will be 5th. Third one will be 4th. Fourth one will be 3. Fifth one will be 2. And then last one would be 1. As you may know, the maximum overlay you can add is 6, which we are maxed out already. So we are going to go to the next bit. And then go back to the first overlay track, click on it, split, and then delete the other part. Just repeat the same process with the other overlay, click on split, and then delete the other one. Then click on the first overlay track, add overlay, and then zoom in, and then move it right behind the first one so it doesn't have a gap. in transition. You can see the other one is kind of blocking the line. What you can do is move it back till you don't see it. Then click on the clip, click on mask, split. Then just repeat the same process of what we did with the first 6 overlay. And then you can see there's one more bit. Just click on split and then delete it. And then in a new one. And you want to trim all the overlays to match the end of the main video. So this is what we have, which might look a little bit weird. You're going to export it. Then click on new project. Select the video we just export. Overlay, add overlay, photos. Select the picture without the background. Zoom in to fill the screen. And then align with the entire video. So that's how you can create this edit. Pretty much you just match the beat. Then use the mask function to cover up part of the video to match whatever picture you use. Pretty easy, right? If you found this video to be helpful, please consider hitting the like button and subscribe to my channel. As always, please be nice to yourself and have a wonderful day. I will see you next time.